This is going to be a hard video. If you know anything about me in this channel, you know I've reviewed Taskade and ToDoIst probably secondarily to Notion. I know TickTick's in there somewhere, but like, shoo for now. I really enjoy the functionality of all of these applications that I talk about and I don't rip on. And while I am a big Notion fanboy, I think Taskade and ToDoIst are some of the best priced options. We look at the free option for Taskade. It's really good. From the standpoint that you can have unlimited tasks and projects, folders, teams, members and guests, templates, calendars, recurring tasks, awesome stuff. You can even do phone calls on there and video chats. It's crazy. The file uploading is actually not bad. The Google Drive integration is not bad. And then for ToDoIst, you do get unlimited tasks and stuff for free. Small amount of uploads, little amount of filters, and then not much activity history. But the $4 a month pro version is, God, it's good. I mean, you get 300 active projects, which is pretty much more than anyone could ask for. You have 25 collaborators per project. You have large file uploads, pretty much unlimited filters, reminders, themes and auto backups. And then for pro, it's the business side of things. You get a little bit more. You get to have a team inbox. You get to have team billing and admin and member roles. So the pro version of Taskade pretty much just allows for like two-way calendar integrations like with Google Calendar, which you can get for free with Todoist, and just better version history. But really quickly, something that ToDoIst falls behind on is the fact that it only has two views. It only has a list view and a board view, and that actually can only be found within projects. You can only switch between these with Shift V in the good old projects view here, which I'm not a huge fan of, to be honest. I really wish that they would give us more than these two. Even the upcoming view here doesn't really have a calendar and you can't go back. That's a big flaw in ToDoIst. But the list, I mean, it is really nice. It has some of the best natural language processing and best quick capture ever. If I go here and press Alt Q anywhere on my computer, if I just go to my homepage, press Alt Q, it'll allow me to type in a not important task for Rise Productive tomorrow at 5 p.m. And I did all that and it's gonna pop in to Rise Productive and it added this not important task for tomorrow at 5 p.m. just like that. There is quick add in Taskade. So if we check out here, there is the option to have a quick add and you can make a task do slash tomorrow. If we go here and add it to the project, it's a little clunkier. See, I wasn't able to quickly do it like that. But if we go into here, you can do slash check, turn it into a checkbox and then slash tomorrow. It'll put in the time really quickly. So I can put tomorrow 5 p.m. It'll change it. And then I can put tell at Dimitri to stop making bad videos. So the functionality here is fine. And you can move between a lot of different projects and a lot of different views. Like in this weekly planner view, I not only get this default one, but I get a board one, just like in ToDoIst. I get a calendar one, which even has a week view and a month view. I get an action view, which is table. Get a mind map and I get an org chart one. So the ability and the variability that exists within Taskade is superior. Like I won't lie, it's superior. And even the mobile apps on both of them look pretty similar and feel pretty good. So I'm not gonna act like either mobile app is really that much better, but it's not the best option to go on your phone for a productivity app ever. I think the simplicity and UI of ToDoIst is less clunky than Taskade, and the whole quick capture idea and the fact that you can work through a lot of this stuff easier. Yes, there's tabs within Taskade, which is cool. There's a My Task view, there's a calendar view, there's a history and recent view, but all you really do need is within ToDoIst. And if you want to add more, you can add filters. And the filters and label section is really customizable. I have a whole ToDoIst course if you do want to check it out in the link down below so you can see more on how to make things like these nice filters. But a big problem that I do have with ToDoIst versus Taskade is that one, Taskade is not integratable with a lot of things. It's an all-in-one solution, but you can integrate it with like Google Calendar, but good Lord, it costs money. Like I'm not one to be like, oh no, I have to pay. Like I get sponsored and or given these free apps for review. I get it, I'm in a privileged position. But the fact that the average user can't just sync this to their Google Calendar is a little bothersome considering they actually have a calendar view. Like ToDoIst makes up for the fact that it doesn't have a calendar by having a nice calendar view. Like type in a task for 5 p.m. tomorrow. It's right here, this is exactly what's gonna be here and I can change the time on this and I can change the default amount of time that's spent on this. right here. And I can add multiple different projects to this. I can easily integrate it with Twist, which is a nice little chat app. I can integrate it with Morgan and pretty much any daily planner app on the market, whereas Taskade does not have nearly the amount of integrations. If you're gonna go for a free app where you wanna actually track what you did in the past, maybe go with Taskade. If you're okay with the lack of version history and like being able to see tasks you did a week ago, honestly, just go with ToDoIst if you don't care, if you're just trying to keep track of tasks as you're doing them, go with ToDoIst. And if you want that stuff in the past and willing to pay $4 a month, go with ToDoIst. I think it is the superior of the two applications because while CalendarView may be nice, you can always sync it with your Google Calendar, and that kind of like is a workaround in a sense, because when you have this as a CalendarView, you know, so it's fine. It allows for actual time blocking, unlike with Taskade, which I have a video talking about how Taskade time blocking is pretty much broken. And even if it did work well, the calendar view for like the day and the week view is not good and breaks constantly. But either way, you're going to be decently happy with your choice. But you'll be even more happy with this video on how to improve your productivity even more.